Welcome students, today we'll be starting with the new session of chapter 5 seeds and seeds. In this chapter we will be learning about different kinds of seeds and how the seed germination, that is the growing of a new plant from a seed. So generally what is a seed? Seed is a smallest part of a plant out of which a new plant grows out. Okay, so we'll help with the help of a small story we'll start of this chapter. So as you can see, some seeds have been placed near the name of the chapter. So Gopal was waiting for his Mausi's family to visit them. They will be coming the next day for their holidays. He was thinking about all the fun and nice food that he would have with his cousins. So he is waiting for the cousins and relatives to come and spend the holidays. Just then his mother called out, "Gopal, before you sleep, remember to soak two balls, that is katoris of chana gram, that is a yellow color pulse." Okay, she was going to his bua's house and would return only in morning. So as he was soaking the chana, Gopal thought, how will two small balls of this would be enough for 8 persons? So many people are coming, and he thought and he tried to use his intelligent brain that these are very small balls. How can this be enough for the 8 persons when they want to cook the pulse? So what he do? He soak another two balls of chana. So when his mother returned next morning, she saw that chana was overflowing from the vessel. So soaking means he put chana with water over it. So what happened when the chana soak and absorb whole water? The chana becomes double in size. So how much did you soak? Asked his mother. How did it happen? Wondered Gopal. So as you can see in the picture also, the gram, which is chana, is overflowing the bowl. So why this happened? You soaked too much. Anyway, it is good. Now I will cook half of them and leave the other half to sprout. So sprout, I'll tell you what is a sprout. Sprout is a process of soaking the seed or pulses in water so that a new plant can grow out of there. So we use the green gram dal as a sprout, chana as a sprout. So these sprouts are very healthy for eating as a raw. अगर उनको कच्चा खाएंगे दे विल बी फुल ऑफ प्रोटीन. सो आई कैन सेंड दीज टू योर आंट, द डॉक्टर हैज टोल्ड हर टू ईट स्प्राउट्स. सो डॉक्टर ऑलवेज टेल टू ईट स्प्राउट बिकॉज देयर हैज हेल्दी. शी टाइड हाफ ऑफ सोक चना इन अ वेट क्लॉथ एंड हंग देम टू स्प्राउट. सो उनकी मम्मी ने, गोपाल की मम्मी ने क्या किया? शी पुट हाफ ऑफ द चना इन अ वेट क्लॉथ सो दैट the seed germination process, the roots coming out, the root which is will come out of the chana, they will take place, and with the help of wet cloth. Why wet cloth is used? Because so that suppose the chana is getting dry, it will take the water from the wet cloth. Okay, so as you can see, this is the picture of chana sprout. These long root kind of structure which is coming out of chana, these when they absorb water, a new plant is coming out, that is called sprout. So what is the process to make sprout? Take some chana and three balls. So activity you have done in fourth class. Okay, try another one, you can do at home also. Take some chana and put three balls. Put five chana in first bowl and fill it up with the water. So five chanas ko lo aur ek bowl ke andar pani mein dal ke rakh do. Now put a damp piece of cloth and put some cotton wool in second bowl. So एक कपड़ा या some cotton ले सकते हो, उसको second bowl में रखो. Now put some number of chanas in it and make sure the wool or cloth remains wet. So जो कपड़े में या वो cotton wool के अंदर आप चना रख रहे हो वो गीला होना चाहिए. Now put same number of chanas in third bowl but don't put anything and cover all three bowls. So after 2 or 3 days you will notice that the chanas we put in second bowl where the cloth or the cotton wool was wet, the sprouts, the seed germination is taking place at a faster rate. But in the first bowl where their chana was immersed in the water, the chana is not taking place for seed germination. And in the third bowl, where the chanas only, there are, nothing is happening there. So now come to the PPT. First, let's read about the. So we get seeds from different plants only. Okay, so to grow any kind of a plant, we need seeds. Suppose we are looking at the first picture. This is rice seed. Then flower, watermelon. Watermelon, to grow watermelon, we need the black color seeds, which is present in the watermelon only. Same for cucumber, then pine cone and other nuts. So as you are seeing on the screen, this is called methi dana or fenugreek seed. Okay, out of which only the methi or the fenugreek grows into the plant. So this is one example. Another, this is the coriander seed, which is used in a powder form also, in a form of coriander also, that is kothambri. And this is the sesame seed, which is placed in our paratha and some baking items. And this is the mustard seed, which is, you can be used for making the mustard oil also, and for growing the small plant also. So what's inside a seed? Seeds have a small plant inside. So this is an animation picture depicting. So before moving that, I'll show you a different one. So where do seed come from? Seed come from the plants only. So in the picture you can see there is a corn. Each kernel of corn is a seed. So each small part, each small kernel, this small part is also a seed. So seed can grow into a tall tree. First they'll grow into a small plant, then they go into a tree. A seed can grow into a tiny flower. So out of the seed, tiny flower plant can also grow. A seed can become a pumpkin plant on a sunflower. Seeds grow into many different kinds of plant. So every plant or tree or herb or shrub, they grow out of the seed only. Now as you can see in the picture, a lot of watermelon is there, and on the left hand side you can see these black colored seeds. Sometimes we swallow also while eating the watermelon. Out of these seeds only the watermelon grows out. And you are looking at the picture of the apple seed. When we eat the apple, inside that seed also present. What do seeds need to grow? Seeds need water. The rain, rain is water. The rain helps many seed to grow. Suppose sometimes we think that right now rainy season is going on, that we do not give water to the plants till the water, plants grow at a very higher speed. So where do they get the water? They get the water from the rain. Moving on. Seed also need good soil. Seed grow up through the soil. As you can see, a shovel is being stuck in the soil to dig out the soil so that we can plant some new seed. Seeds need sunlight, soil, water, sunlight, and what most need to become a plant. Suppose you are planting a seed in soil and you are not planting it at a place where sunlight is not coming, then the seed will not grow into a plant. Okay, whatever you do, if the seed is not getting enough sunlight, the plant will not grow and not will become tree. So now you know how to plant, you are ready to plant your own seed. You can put fenugreek or coriander seeds at your home in the flower pot also, so that these plants can grow and you can utilize while making the vegetables out of it. So why, what do seeds need to grow? Air, water, sunshine and minerals. Minerals, different kinds of minerals they get from soil. Sunshine from sun, water you can give, and air is present everywhere. So these are the things required for the, watch the seed grow. So first of all, in the first picture you can see that we have placed the seed under a soil layer. Then slowly a small part of plant is growing out of that seed, and then it is taking a bigger place. Seeds growing into a plant. So you can see the small parts of seeds and the small part of plants are coming out of the soil. Okay. What can you do with seeds? So we can eat the seeds also in form of pulses. Suppose rajma, chana, dal, green gram, these are seeds. We can collect it, we can study, we can make different things. We can paste on the paper with the help of fevicol, and we can make different things using different seeds. Here are some seeds that you can eat. The first is pea, second is corn, third is imli, that is tamarind. Then coconut is also a kind of seed, strawberry, sunflower. So these are the some examples of सीड सीड्स मेक वेजिटेबल प्लांट्स, वी ईट वेजिटेबल्स सच एज कैरेट, पी, पम्पकिन, कॉर्न, पोटेटो, क्यूकम्बर. सो दीज आर द फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स और वेजिटेबल्स वी गेट फ्रॉम सीड्स. सो नाउ सीड्स मेक फ्रूट प्लांट्स ऑल्सो सच एज बनाना, एप्पल, वाटरमेलन, ऑरेंज, पाइन एप्पल एंड दिस इज आई थिंक पियर. दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ पियर. ओके सो हाउ सीड्स आर प्लांटेड, सीड फॉल ऑन टू द ग्राउंड. सो हाउ सीड्स आर जनरली प्लांटेड, सपोज वी आर नॉट पुटिंग इन द ग्राउंड, सो सीड्स कैन फॉल ऑन टू द ग्राउंड. सपोज वी आर ईटिंग समथिंग और समबडी इज थ्रोइंग ऑन द, सपोज एज यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर ऑल्सो, दिस इज अ फार्मर हु इज थ्रोइंग द सीड्स इन द ग्राउंड. सीड्स कैन, सीड्स आर वेरी लाइट इन वेट, सो दे कैन बी कैरिड बाय विंड. ओके सीड्स आर कैरिड बाय वाटर ऑल्सो, सीड्स कैन कैरी बाय द एनिमल्स. समटाइम्स सीड्स स्टक टू द बॉडी और स्किन ऑफ द एनिमल्स एंड एनिमल मूव फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर सच एज स्क्वायरल, रैबिट. एंड सीड्स आर प्लांटेड बाय पीपल, सो वेन पीपल आर प्लांटिंग द सीड्स इट इज कॉल्ड फार्मिंग. दे आर ग्रोइंग लॉट ऑफ क्रॉप इन द फार्मिंग. सम ऑफ द क्रॉप्स ग्रो इन आर फील्ड सच एज बाजरा, वीट, राइस, मेज. जर्नी ऑफ सीड फ्रॉम फील्ड टू मार्केट, सो फर्स्ट प्रोसेस इज प्लोइंग द लैंड. प्लोइंग द लैंड मीन्स लूजिंग द सैंड सो दैट वेन वी आर पुटिंग द सीड्स दे कैन ईजली ग्रो आउट ऑफ द लैंड. आफ्टर प्लोइंग सोइंग, सोइंग मीन्स थ्रोइंग और पुटिंग द सीड्स इन टू द सॉइल. ट्रेडिशनल मैन्योरिंग, मैन्योरिंग मीन्स वी आर प्रोवाइड अ गुड क्वालिटी ऑफ मैन्योर और फर्टिलाइजर टू द लैंड सो दैट एनी काइंड ऑफ अ मिनरल द सीड नीड्स दे कैन गेट फ्रॉम द मैन्योर. प्रोवाइडिंग वाटर, इरीगेशन सिस्टम, बिकॉज वाटर इज ऑल्सो नेसेसरी फॉर ग्रोइंग ऑफ अ प्लांट. एंड वीडिंग एंड ट्रांसप्लांटिंग, वीडिंग मीन्स टू रिमूविंग अनवॉन्टेड प्लांट्स एंड ट्रांसप्लांटिंग मीन्स सपोज वेन द योर सीड्स आर रेडी यू कैन प्लांट इन अ गुड फील्ड. एंड हार्वेस्टिंग द प्लांट, हार्वेस्टिंग द प्लांट मीन्स वंस द क्रॉप इज रेडी यू कैन टेक आउट द क्रॉप फ्रॉम योर फार्म्स. एंड थ्रैशिंग द वीट फ्रॉम द प्लांट बाय मैन, सो थ्रैशिंग द मीन्स टू रिमूविंग द ग्रेन और द सपोज राइस, वीट, बाजरा, रिमूविंग ऑल दीज मटीरियल्स फ्रॉम द बिगर पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट. दिस इज कॉल्ड थ्रैशिंग द वीट. Transport and storage of grains, such as we brought rice or wheat at home in a form of packet of sacks. So once the grain is coming from the farms, they are put into a sacks and they are transported from one place to another. So tools used for farming, such as thriller, we will not go in detail. This is a thriller. It is used to plow the land. Okay. Then tractor also used to plow. So many different things we can use with the help of tractor. Crawler tractor for doing heavy earth moving. Paddy thresher, so from one side in this machine we can put one side of crop and other side will get grain and the waste will go on the different side. Combine harvester, so this is a machine which is very popular in India. What this machines do, this machines cut the crop at the same time. Inside the machine the crop is been divided into the waste and the grains. Grains alag ho jata aur waste alag ho jata hai aur same time pe cutting bhi kar deta hai. Transplanter, so this machine is used to put different kinds of seeds or small plants into the land. Okay, very important. So as you can see in the picture, the person is putting lot of small plants and he is using the transplanter in the field. So now he is not doing labor work by putting the planter with the help of hand. Reaper, so reaper as the name suggests, this machine is used to cut down the plants. So when the crop grows and they are need to be harvested, this machine can be used to cut down the crop. Multi crop thresher, so any kind of a crop which is grown, they can be put from this side and the grains and waste will come from another side. And see raised bed planter, so we don't have to make after plowing land, we don't have to make different kinds of layer of soil to make the beds for planting seeds. This machine can be used for that. So different machines are there. Okay, so that's all for today. I will be posting a video of seed germination also in the WhatsApp group. Thank you, have a nice day.